Sure, of course.
Gary, the question about the governor's directive, she has started a process that is going to take a while.
Yeah, I can speak a little bit about the timeline of her directive. So it, a broad directive came out in April, which was just that the Oregon Health Authority and the Oregon Department of Education need to work together to come up with a systematic approach to protect our kids from lead in schools. And so that process has been unfolding as we've been working together, we as an OHA and the Oregon Department of Education. So we're the process is still unfolding as far as how that's going to be details of that. We plan to have some actual, like a draft proposal for by the early summer. And then the hope would be that we would implement it certainly in time for the fall school year. So that's kind of the timeline. So. So no one really has any, no school districts in the state have any detailed information at this time. Like I said, the protocols would be unfolding.
Why didn't you follow up?
Excuse me?
Why didn't you follow up with work folks?
In what regard?
You said that you had to notice in April.
Unless I'm misunderstanding your question. In April was when Governor Brown.
Yes, you said the record.
Right, and it was a broad directive without very many details. And so, and we aren't focusing, this is a statewide directive. And so, this is more of an announcement that.
We're talking about kids. You got mothers here. I'm concerned. I'm a grandparent.
I hear you, Mr. Broussard, but I just want to say that already before the governor issued her directive, Portland Public Schools, I think, committed to or started talking about program to test all in schools this summer. So in this case, PPS was actually ahead of the curve. I can't.
Oh, are you kidding me?
I said
ahead of the curve.
Excuse me, sir. I said in this respect, and the issue of how this affects us as a state is a big one, and it's going to require the legislature to come up with funding for the schools to be able to do this around the state. This is an important conversation. And it's going to be a real debate, and it's going to be a real challenge. We have to find the money as a state to be able to do this.
How about
so
the city?
Thank you.
How about the city? The city is a big challenge. When did they get the work?
Why
did they respond?
Yeah, I believe this is an aspect of state funding of education, first of all. But, yes.
But I did ask a question of the superintendent. Would she share with us today as to whether or not she should continue on her job?
You know, I think we're going to move on to the next
question.
Absolutely. And anyway,
I'm focused on kids right now, and I'm focused on figuring out how this doesn't happen again and how we have a plan for going forward, so.
Thank you, Brad.
Yeah, and thank you for asking the question, Bruce.